This is a continuation of the review. The topic is random variables, and the other related topics are common random value distributions, random variable distributions being uniform, Bernoulli, binomial, geometric, and Poisson. So, the way we define a random variable x can take values, and they're usually values. For example, let's take a simple example of x can take numerical values of 1, 2, let's say 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is a six-sided dice, for example, where x can take all these values. So we say that x is a random variable here, which is the outcome of a dice, and the outcome is assigned a numerical value 1, 2, 6. Now, if let's say a different random variable y, which is a coin toss can take two values, heads and tails. But in order for it to be a random variable, we have to assign a numerical value for the heads and for tails. So let's say a numerical value for heads is 1 and the numerical value for tails is 0, then that would be my assigned numerical value. So the random variable here, y, takes the value 1 and 0 when the coin is heads or the coin is tails accordingly. So one of the things that we often want to know about a random variable then is, this is a random variable, these are the values of x it takes. So if I asked what the probability of x taking a value of, let's say, 2 is, then that will be given by my probability. So this is the probability of x taking the value some x's. So x taking the value 2 is 1 over 6, because if this is a fair dice, then the probability of each of them is 1 over 6 and 1 over 6 and so on. Now, this is a simple example of a probability of a random variable and its associated probabilities. Now, in the case of a coin toss, and let's assume that this was a biased coin, and there was more likelihood, or 70% chance, that there was that the coin would turn out heads, and a 30% chance that it would turn out tails, then this is my probability that y takes a certain value, lowercase y. This is the notation we use, and we call this table, which is nothing but the probability mass function. So the probability mass function is telling you what the probability of that x takes a numerical value lowercase x is. So we can also write, for example, that for the case of the coin toss, this is 1 over 6 as for x being between 1 and 6, and it's 0 otherwise. So that's one way of writing it. Now, the kind of probabilities, random variables we looked at, we said that we can express them as a table. For example, I could have some random variable x, let's say, which can take values of, let's say that it only takes 4 different values, and they're 1, 2, 3, and 4, and the probabilities are given to us as, let's say, 0.7, 0.1, let's say 1, 5, and so that's 0.95, and let's make this point so that's going to be 0.05, or is it, well, that's still point 7, 8, 9, 0.95, 0.05. Yeah, so the sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. So one of the rules we know then is the probability, the sum of the probabilities for all x should be equal to 1, which is basically the axiom for probabilities. And so this is my probability that now the more common distributions have some pattern to them rather than some arbitrary probabilities assigned to them. So these are the common ones we saw in class, and I'm gonna, let me scale this a little bit so we can write our other stuff. And so let's move it. So the ones we saw were the uniform random random variable, the Bernoulli binomial, geometric, and Poisson. So the things of interest to us then are, in a uniform random variable, this uniform random variable, the plot looks something like this. This is A and B, and we're saying that the probability of A, the probability of B, and anything in between A and B are all equally likely. And this is my probability, this value here is given by 1 by B minus A plus 1, which is this value right here. So, which also tells me, so if these are my x values, that values x can take, and this is the probability of x for a given value k. So where k lies between, k is a plus 1 all the way up to b. Now the expected value of a random variable is given by the formula, the summation of the numerical value, all numerical values that it can take, times the probability that that numerical value is taken. So for all x, so so for example, the expected value of the uniform distribution we calculated is a plus b by 2. Similarly, the variance of x, the definition of variance of x, is the expected value of the difference of x minus the expected value of x squared. So what this is saying is, take each, for each value that x can take, how much does it depart from its mean, which is the expected value, and square that difference, that, and take this all possible differences that you can have. So that's the definition of variance of x, and that comes out to be a b minus a times b minus a plus 2 by 12 for the uniform distribution. So we typically say, and for example we could have written these as this here, we say if x is a uniform distribution with parameters a comma b, then this is the PMF for it, and this is the mean, and that's the variance. Now similarly, if x were a random variable which is Bernoulli, and remember that Bernoulli is used to describe events where there can only be two values, either heads or tails, success or failure, and so on. So if the probability of success is given as p, and on success x takes a value of 1, and on failure x takes a value of 0, we say that it's a Bernoulli random variable. And Bernoulli random variable has a mean of p and a variance of p times 1 minus p. In fact, this is probably one of the ones that is easier to derive in very short in just a couple of steps, because we can say that the expected value of a Bernoulli random variable x is given by, so x can take a value of 1, and the probability that it takes a value of 1 is p, so 1 times p, plus it can take a value of 0, and the probability that it takes a value of 0 is 1 minus p. So this is simply 0 times 1 minus p plus p, that's just p. So how about the variance of x for a Bernoulli random variable? Well, the variance of x is, again, it can take a value, so we're looking at the expected value of x minus the expected value of x squared. So we know that expected value of x is p, so it's 1 minus p square, which is the difference between the first value 1, which is the first value x being 1, minus the mean, which is p square, and the probability that this will occur is given as by p, plus the second difference is 0 minus p square, because that's 0 minus p square, and the probability that this will occur is 1 minus p. Now this is given by, if I take 1 minus p as being common to both of these, then that's 1 minus p, so that's p minus p square plus p square, because that's 0 minus p, that's p. So that's gonna go there, and so this is p times 1 minus p, which is our value right there. So we saw that similarly n Bernoulli trials give us a binomial random variable. So this is the random variable x here then is said to be binomial, and the parameters are n and p, because what x, the random variable x which is binomial is saying is, what is the, it says k out of n successes where each event is Bernoulli distributed. So we have n experiments performed, and we want to see what is the probability that k of those experiments will result in a success. And so the random variable x is describes this value k, where k can be one success all the way up to n successes. So k can take values between, actually k can take even a value of 0, which is there are no successes, all the way up to n successes. So this is given, the PMF for this is given by n choose k with p to the power of k times 1 minus p to the power of n minus k. We derived this in class, and the reasoning behind this is that the number of ways we can choose k out of n is n choose k. Now the, in order for me to have exactly k successes, it means that k of them have to be successes and the remaining of them have to be failures. The probability of k successes is p to the power of k, because each of these events is independent, and the probability of n minus k failures is 1 minus p to the power of n minus k. So this gives us the binomial random variable, and the mean for the binomial random variable, or the expected value, is given by np, and the variance is given by np times 1 minus p. And we saw examples of the use of the binomial random